Lewis is live for us with more on this story tonight. Sean?
Yeah, Chicago police clear about this one, Joe and Micah, that this was a targeted attack, and they are linking this murder with the shooting of that Chicago firefighter about 3 weeks ago. The building at the corner of Francisco and Montrose tonight is quiet, even as the events of less than 24 hours ago are still on the minds of those who live nearby. Police say the 27-year-old Stephanie Brooks was shot in the chest and killed about 9:30 Monday night. Investigators believe a masked gunman dressed in black got into the building and knocked on the door of the second floor apartment. The man who lives there opened the door and then struggled to close it when the gunman tried to force his way in. Brooks, who was a guest of that residence, was shot and died at the scene.
I heard commotion above me, and then I heard a pop. And I was hoping and praying that, you know, that wasn't what I thought I heard, a gunshot.
Brooks was a mother of three young children, including a 7-year-old daughter and 1-year-old twins, and was a familiar face on this block. Employees at the 7-Eleven just across the street say she was a frequent customer, often coming in with her kids. The concern for police are the possible gang ties to her killing and the possibility, they say, that this was retaliation for a gang-related shooting on February 2nd that happened less than a mile away on Wilson near Kimball, in which a Chicago firefighter was caught in the crossfire and shot in the leg. One of the men arrested in that, police say, has a connection to Brooks.
It looks like a targeted attack. They knew who they were coming for.
The alderman for the 33rd Ward today is concerned about the possible escalation of violence.
I have a meeting with the mayor this afternoon, and we're going to be talking about what resources are going to be sent this way in order to be able to address this wave of increased violence.
Increased violence on this normally quiet street in which neighbors say they are taking extra precautions.
It's just tragic. You know, it's just tragic. I mean, the woman, you know, for a mother of three to be killed like that, it's just tragic.
I don't feel safe. I feel like that the uptick needs to cease. All of the unnecessary crime throughout our city, period, it needs to cease.
A neighborhood anti-violence coalition is planning an event next week, positive loitering event, they say, simply hoping that their presence out in the on the streets here on the city's northwest side will help curb some of the violence that they've seen over the past several months. We are live tonight in Ravenswood Manor. Sean Lewis, WG.